Hi guys, welcome back to another tutorial on Ansys, and in today's tutorial I'll be showing you how to do assembly in Ansys Workbench. So let's begin with the procedure. Just right click and go for new component system and select geometry. Give it a name as Clevis device. Enter. Right click on geometry and go for new geometry. This will open the design modeler where I'm going to design, where I'm going to sketch my model. So it will take few seconds maybe. Right now it's starting. Yeah. So right now I'm in design modeler. First thing I'm going to do is go for units and select inches and start the sketch with the XY plane. Look at, go for sketching, select polyline and start your sketch. Start your sketch and right click and go for close end. So then go for constraints, select vertical and select this line, this line, this line. So all my lines are perfect. Next, go for equal length, select this line and this line, this line and this line, this one and this one. Done with the equal length. Now go for symmetry, like this one, this one, this. Okay, control Z. When you go for symmetry, select the axis first and then the two lines. Same thing with this one and this one. So then go for okay, go for fillet. This one and this one. Go for fillet. Type in radius 0.5. Select this one and this one. Also this one and this one. Same over here. And here also this one and this one. Now go for dimensions, select general here. Okay, control Z. I want vertical dimensions, so this one and this one, this one and this one. Okay. This is going to over constraint, so I'm not going for it. Okay, so this dimension is 0.25. Correct. Next, general. This one is also 0.25 and this one is 1. And next dimension will be general from here to here. This distance is 0.125. Okay. Modify. Select coincident and select this point and this point. Perfect. Now go for dimensions from here. Control Z. Horizontal from here to this one. This is 2.625. Okay, modify constraints equivalent equal radius. From this point to this point, this one is 1.675. Okay. Zero point 125 again. So last thing that I have to do is constraint select coincident this point and this point. Control Z. So yeah, my sketch is done. Oh, one more thing. Okay. So one more equal length. Equal radius. Equivalent, where is equivalent? This thing on this thing. So now my sketches looks perfect. So next go for extrude and direction will be symmetric 0.5 inches 0.5. Go for isometric generate. So this Clevis feature is done. Now I want to make few holes on this part and this part. So for that, select this yoke upper portion and go for new plane, generate, go on this plane and say look at. Okay, so I did some mistakes. Just delete this plane. Yes. And select this one. New plane. Generate, select the plane and go for sketching. Look at. So next go for is sketching. Select this oval. Oh, sorry. Select this oval. And go for dimensions. Select this one. And it is 0.5 again. Distance from, okay, horizontal distance, distance from this one to this axis, it's 0.5, and again from this to this, it's also 0.5, and the distance between this point and this point is also 0.5. Okay, sorry, 0.25. Okay, this one is 0.5 by 2, yani 0.25. No, perfect. So then go for isometric view, go for extrude, and this time operation will be cut material. And direction will be okay. and type through all, and let's check. Yeah, perfect. So the whole part is done. Now we need to add a stem and a pin between these two holes, like from extending from this hole to this hole, one rod and a stem with the pin will be added. So for that, first right click this one part, one body, and suppress this one. Okay, next we'll create the stem, and for that let's select XZ plane and say look at, go for sketching, select a rectangle and start drawing. Also circle somewhere over here, go for dimensions, so go for dimensions and select this one between this. Okay, skip. I need to check. Okay, let's draw a circle. Over here. Okay, so go for dimensions. Select general, select this one. This one and this axis between this line and this axis, control Z, that will be our vertical between these two, and diameter of this circle as well as horizontal between this and this, also between this and this. Oh, then let's go for the values. Diameter will be 0.5, this length will be 0.5 always, also this is 0.5, this element will be 4, and this is 1.125, and 0.625. So done with the sketching, let's switch to modeling and go for extrude. Let's extrude. In the operation, this time select air frozen. Direction will be both symmetric. Depth will be 1. Generate, so I'll go for isometric. Select and suppress. So as you can see, the stem part is done. Next I'm going to add a pin. So for that, click exit plane and create a new plane. Now say generate, select your plane and go for sketching. Go for sketching and then select a circle. Go for dimensions. Select diameter. Give it a diameter of 1 inch. And the distance of this circle from this axis is 0.125. Okay, my bad, the diameter is 0.5 inches. So the pin is done, switch to modeling. Go for extrude, I'll just switch to isometric. And go for add frozen. Direction is both symmetric. And depth is 1.25. Generate. So as you can see, the pin is, so this is the final assembly of the Clevis device. I hope you guys like this, and if you have any doubts, feel free to comment in the video and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. I'll be bringing you more videos very soon. Thank you so much and peace.